Good morning, Dumelang, Tobela, Abusheni, hello, Khoyimore, and a warm welcome to this week's service. My name is Thabang and I am the Young Adults and Youth Pastor at Bryanston Methodist Church. It is always a humbling experience and privilege to come to you and to lead you in a space of worship. And I thank God for the privilege that we can be able to continue worshiping even when we are under lockdown, even when we cannot physically meet. We also thank God for the fact that He remains a God who does not only reside in a church building, but He's a God who is spirit. He's a God who is everywhere. And also, friends, as Jesus appeared to His disciples when they were under lockdown and offered them peace, allow me, friends, this morning to offer you peace of the Lord, and may peace of the Lord be with you. If you are having a birthday today, happy birthday to you, and God bless you, and may He answer all your prayers, give you all that you need, and give you all that you need, but you don't know that you need because you're not praying for, or you are not aware that you need that. May God richly and abundantly bless you. And now let us begin the service with a word of prayer, and let us pray. Lord, today we recall your faithfulness and thank you that you walk with us every day. Thank you that you are with us in each moment of our lives. Thank you that your promises are true and your goodness never fails us. In this moment, Lord God, we come to you and we lay our lives before you. May we worship you, adore you in every fiber of our being. May everything within us cry, "Holy is the Lord God Almighty who was and is to come." And so today we join all those who worship you today and confess you as Lord. From generations past and present, with all angels that sing in heaven of your greatness and beauty. Lord, we adore you. Lord, we love you. And Lord, you are precious to us. Be with us, Lord, as we begin the service. And may your Holy Spirit move as your word is preached. And may lives be changed and inspired by your word. This we pray in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so high. Upon the before me. Here I am to worship. Oh God, you're wonderful to me.
Friends, today we meet on the 94th day of lockdown in our country. We are on level 3, others are calling it level 3 advanced. And throughout the week, I have been checking the numbers and the numbers are rising very rapidly, that it's so scary. We have also been learning of the number of teachers and learners that are getting infected. Indeed, it is getting scary by the day. It is actually scary at the moment. I saw a post on social media of someone said, coronavirus is now closer to us than before. We don't just know the stats, but we also know people closer to us who are infected. Another pandemic that is hitting our country currently is the pandemic of gender-based violences and femicide. My heart sank during the week when I was watching the news and it was reported that two fathers in Mpumalanga raped their children. And I asked myself, what is wrong with us? Because indeed, the world has gone wrong. During the week also, we had Stats SA publish the quarter one stats for unemployment in the country. And we are sadly sitting at 30.1%. And most of these people are black young people in our country. And majority of them are also women. This is only for quarter one. Now, it is also scary that as you look at the current situation that we are in now, companies, we read stories every day of companies retrenching people. We read stories of businesses closing due to COVID-19, due to many other reasons, due to the economy. We indeed live in a very sad time. We have even become a society that is so used to getting bad news and heartbreaking stories. And I try to remember during the week, when was the last time I had or I read the good news? Because everything that we read now is always bad news. Oh, if you are a Liverpool fan, big up to you and congrats. Indeed, God has always been with you. Indeed, God has been God. And he will remain God to you and to all of us. But your story is, after 30 days, you are now the champs. And we find our scripture reading, friends, from Psalm 13. And it is a psalm penned by David. And it reads as follows. How long, Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I wrestle with my thoughts and day after day have sorrow in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me? Look on me and answer me, Lord my God. Give light to my eyes or I will sleep in death and my enemy will say I have overcome him and my foes will rejoice when I fall. But I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing the Lord's praise for he has been good to me. This is the word of God, friends, and thanks be to God. We find the psalm that we just read, Psalm 13, and it is a psalm that was penned by David. David is a man that is called a man after God's own heart. He is a worshiper. He is a man called by God himself. He is a man who has a relationship with God. He is a man who consulted God in everything that he did. He is a man who knows the presence of God. He is a man who always sought God in everything that he did. So friends, chapter 13, as we read, has six verses, which can be divided into three parts. The first part is the problem. In Psalm 13, the first two verses, verse 1 and verse 2, David now presents the problem. The second part is the petition. David calls on to the Lord, and this is in verse 3 and verse 4. And the last part would be the praise in verse 5 and in verse 6. So journey with me, friends, as we go and reflect on these six verses. So when David wrote this psalm, it is clear that he was going through the most. He was going, life was tough. He felt that God is far from him. He felt like God had forgotten him. He felt like God had hidden his face from him. So he was a man going through the most of emotions because God felt like he was distant. He wrestled with thoughts. Day by day, his heart was filled with sorrow. He felt like his enemy is winning. And when David penned this psalm, when his life was in danger, when he was fleeing from King Saul, because King Saul wanted to kill him. In verses 1 and 2, David asked God this question. How long? And if you read verse 1 and 2 again, you can tell that David asked this question 4 times. How long? How long? How long? And how long? It felt like despite David praying to God, God had not answered. It felt like despite David looking for God, God seemed unavailable. It felt like when David was calling and calling and calling, God did not answer. He was in the wilderness, he was in the caves, hoping and waiting for God to say something or to act. But God did nothing. And when we are in trouble, it sometimes seems like God is moving slowly. It sometimes feels like God is not there, or it also feels like God does not want to come to our rescue. We know this feeling. We know the feeling of David. We live in a time of hurry. We live in a time when we want to do things at a certain time. We want to do things in a convenient way. Everything must be done now. Even when we go to God, we want God to answer us now. We want God to do things for us now. This is why people get drawn to anyone who says to them, God says to me, I should tell you this and that, because we are a generation of instancy. And yet God keeps on saying to us, wait. God says to us, wait. When the world says hurry, when we say hurry, God says wait. And we don't like waiting because we want things to happen now. So our greatest trouble is that we are in a hurry and God isn't. So we don't understand, like our biggest frustration is caused by the fact that we are in a hurry and God isn't. Perhaps we look at what we are going through today and we ask like David, Lord, how long? How long must we lose our loved ones due to COVID-19? How long should we endure the pain caused by gender-based violences and femicide and rape? How long must we see young people losing hope due to unemployment? How long must we see our parents frustrated because business is not doing well? How long, Lord? How long must we see them come home and tell us that they are no longer working? How long must we see, Lord God, the abused losing hope? How long must we be abused also because of our race, our gender, and our sexualities? How long, Lord, like David, we ask? How long must we continue to be a society of absent fathers? How long must we be under lockdown? How long, Lord, like David, we ask? And at times, as we reflect like David, it seems like God is distant. He doesn't hear our prayers. So we relate to David's emotions, especially at a time that we find ourselves in the country. So when David penned this psalm, he was going through a lot. And we are also going through a lot of emotions in this time. We, above everything, ask, Lord, when will these things end? When will life go back to normal? So David's enemy also seemed to be winning. Our enemies, sometimes it seems like they are winning. COVID-19, unemployment, rapists, abusers. It seems like our enemies are winning, and we ask God, how long? But the good news is God has not forgotten us. God had not forgotten David. All men and women who thought God had forgotten them in the Bible, God was building their strength and maturity and character. And he came to them to answer them. He came as he promised. He showed them that he had never forgotten or forsaken them. And in all that we are currently going through in our own personal lives, in as society, God has not forgotten us. In all that we are currently going through, especially as youth in South Africa, especially as youth in Africa, especially as youth around the world, God is with us. God is with us. May we not allow what we are going through to tell us that God had forgotten us. May we always be reminded that God is with us. And we move to the second part of Psalm 13, verses 3 and 4, the petition. David calls unto the Lord. When God seemed distant, David didn't decide to give up on God, but rather he called on him. David was sensitive to the presence of God in his life. David pleads with God to look on him and to give light to him, because if not, he will die and the enemy will claim victory. Trouble creates darkness in our lives. Challenges that we are going through personally and as a nation creates darkness in us. That's why we also pray like David, that God, please look on us, that God, please create light in us. We ask like David, God, please look at us. Look at how we live. Look at the pain in our hearts. Look at the pain in our society. Look at us and bring us light, for you are light. And we will win over the enemy. Also, God, give us power to win. Answer our prayers, Lord. Please, we pray like David. And scripture continues to remind us in the book of Psalms that no weapons formed against us shall prosper. No evil against us shall prosper, for God is with us. And Paul says to the Romans, if God is for us, who can be against us? In whatever that we are going through, we need to be simply reminded that God is with us and we shall overcome. Enemies will come, yes. Enemies actually have to come so that our Christian strength is built, Christian character is built, Christian maturity is built. And when enemy come, it also help us realize that we actually need to rely on God for survival, and the enemies that comes to us will not prosper. And the last part of Psalm 13, the praise. David says, but I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing the Lord's praise, for he has been good to me. The situation when David was penning these words had not changed. David was still pursued by Saul. He was running for his life. He was in the cave and Saul was in the throne. But he continues to trust in the unfailing love of God. His heart was filled with joy and he thinks of deliverance that God is going to bring. And in the time of darkness that we find ourselves in the time of uncertainty that we find ourselves in the time of pain that is caused by things that are happening around us, let us learn from David. Let us learn to even give God praise in the midst of darkness, to give God praise in the midst of uncertainty, to give God praise even in the midst of challenges, because indeed he will deliver us. Now David knows that God is going to deliver him. David knows that he will sing praises when God had delivered him. And may I say unto us that may whatever we are going through not make us lose hope and faith in God. For God is going to come to us. God is going to rescue us. God is with us. No matter what we are going through now, God is with us. And as we are now going to prayer, allow me to say to you that David trusted God even in the midst of situations. May we never lose hope. May we never give up on God based on what we are going through. And in this time when God seems distant, in this time when it seems like God is not listening to us, may we look at David and learn from him that even in this time, we still continue to give God the praise, glory, and honor that he deserves. When God seems distant, let us learn from David to call on him, to trust in him, to trust in his unfailing love, his presence, and he will deliver us. And in this, allow me to say, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. And let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you that we relate to David's emotions, we relate to his situations. It might not be the same, but we find ourselves also in a time when people are asking about your presence in the midst of all this, in the midst of gender-based violences, in the midst of COVID-19, in the midst of people losing jobs, in the midst of unemployment. We continue, Heavenly Father, calling unto you because there is no one that we can call unto. There is no person that can understand the pain of our hearts. There is no person that can understand the depth of our prayers. That's why, Heavenly Father, we come to you. We come to you, Lord God, like David, knowing and trusting in your unfailing love. We come to you, Heavenly Father, like David, knowing, Heavenly Father, that you, only you deserve to be asked this question. How long? Because you understand you have all the world in your hands. We understand, Heavenly Father, that it is only you that we need to plead with to look at us, to give us light. It is only you, Heavenly Father, that you deserve our praise, honor, and glory. And all of this, Heavenly Father, we pray, Lord God, that you save us, Lord, from whatever that we are going through. Lord, be with us, Heavenly Father. Make us feel your presence in this time, Lord God, because we know that there is no one alive other than you, Lord God. There is no God alive other than you, Lord God. We pray all of this, Lord God, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we also ask that you be with us in the following week. You continue to bless and protect us, Lord God. You continue to bless and guide the leadership of the nation and all the healthcare staff, Lord God, as they try to fight this disease. And Lord God, we pray all of this in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears have come. Child of God, I'm no longer.